Cornelius Smith. Mr. Smith, good morning. Mr. Smith, we'll ask you to raise your right hand with your handcuffs, so I'm going to tell you you've been indicted by the grand jury of Smith. You're charged in indictment 220014 with the offense of first-degree murder. Mr. Smith, that offense carries a sentence of life in prison. The state of Tennessee could also file a notice to seek the death penalty or to seek life in prison without the possibility of parole. You've also indicted in count two of this case, Mr. Smith, and charged with criminal attempt to commit a felony two with first-degree murder. That Class A felony carries anywhere from 50 to 60 years in prison. Count three, Mr. Smith, charges you with being a convicted felon in possession of a firearm, alleging that you've been convicted of an aggravated assault. That's a felony with statutory elements involved, violence and attempted use of violence. That B felony also carries 8 to 30 years in prison. This offense occurred after July 1st, 2021. That's an 85% sentence, Mr. Smith. If you're convicted of that crime, you got to serve 85% of that sentence. You've also been charged with employing a firearm in the commission of a felony offense. That C felony carries anywhere from 3 to 15 years in prison. The gun charge is a 100% sentence, Mr. Smith. If you're convicted of a gun charge, you have to serve 100% of that sentence, would have to run consecutive to attempted murder. You've also been indicted by the grand jury and charged with theft of property. And that C felony carries anywhere from 3 to 15 years in prison. Mr. Smith, do you understand what you're charged to serve?
Yes, sir.
Mr. Smith, do you have an attorney?
We're looking in the hiring line right now.
You are in the process of trying to hire an attorney right now, sir?
Yes, sir.
Who's going to hire an attorney for you, Mr. Smith?
My family.
Have you talked to an attorney yet?
Yes, we're looking in the hiring
line. Do you know what attorney you're trying to hire, Mr. Smith?
Not at the moment.
Not at the moment. How much time do you need in order to get an attorney hired for you, Mr. Smith?
About another week.
You think you'd have a lawyer in a week, sir?
A week and a half, 2 weeks, yes, sir.
Hey, have a seat for a second. We'll talk to you in a minute, please, sir. I was suggesting Johnson. Mr. Johnson, good morning, sir.
Good morning.
Mr. Johnson, in that indictment 210-3333, you are indicted for the same, similar conduct, rather. Let me rephrase that. In 220014, brother, you're indicted for the same conduct as your co-defendant, Mr. Cornelius Smith. Count one charge you for first-degree murder. Again, that carries a sentence of life in prison if convicted. Life under Tennessee law, Mr. Johnson, is construed to be 60 calendar years. You have to serve 51 years of that sentence before you become eligible for release. Attempted first-degree murder carries 15 to 60 years in prison. Being a convicted felon in possession of a firearm carries 8 to 30 years in prison. Employing a firearm in commission of attempted murder carries anywhere from 6 to 15 years in prison. That gun charge is 100% sentence, Mr. Johnson. If you're convicted of using a gun, employing a gun in attempted murder, you'd have to serve a minimum sentence of 6 years at 100%. No sentence would have to run consecutively. You've also been indicted for theft of property. That C felony carries 3 to 15 years in prison. You have a second indictment. That apparently was superseded by the other indictment, which I just read into the record. 12103333 charged for first-degree murder, attempted first-degree murder, and theft of property. Now, do you understand the charges against you, Mr. Johnson?
Yes, sir.
Do you have an attorney, sir?
I'm working on it.
You're working on hiring an attorney. Mr. Johnson, who's going to hire an attorney for you, sir?
Okay.
How long will it take you to get a lawyer, Mr. Justin Johnson? How much time do you want to continue your case so that you and your family can hire an attorney, sir?
2 weeks.
Mr. Johnson, if you tell me to Judge Coffee, I cannot afford an attorney, I will appoint an attorney for you. Do you understand it, sir?
I can afford one.
You can afford an attorney. Mr. Smith, stand up for a second also. Mr. Smith, if you tell me that you cannot afford an attorney, I will appoint a lawyer for you also. Do you understand it, sir?
Yes, sir.
You tell me that you can afford an attorney.
Yes, sir.
Mr. Johnson, Mr. Smith, you do not need the court to appoint an attorney for you. Is that correct?
No,
Mr. Smith, you told me you can have an attorney hired in a week or two. Yes, Mr. Johnson, you told me you don't know how long it would take you to hire an attorney.
I don't know. My people got to do, you know, they I don't know. I can't say.
When would you like to be back in court so you can let me know whether or not you were able to hire an attorney, Mr. Johnson?
About a week.
About a week.
About a week.
Mr. Hacker, do you have this case with the state, Mr. Griffiths?
Yes, sir.
You're both asking for a week, is that correct?
I should know something in a week.
Of next week, the 28th of January, is the day for you.
That's just fine, Judge.
Yes, sir.
Mr. Smith, Mr. Johnson, I'm going to continue your case until Friday, January 28th. That would give you about 9 days to see if you get a lawyer hired. Now, if you come back on Friday, the 28th of January, and you tell me that you cannot afford an attorney, I will appoint an attorney for you. I will appoint a private lawyer for you, somebody who's qualified to handle the most serious cases in the state of Tennessee. I will appoint a lawyer for you if you tell me you cannot hire an attorney. Now, I cannot let you sit in jail week after week, month after month without an attorney because it would violate your rights. Do you understand this, sir? Mr. Johnson, do you have any questions, sir? Mr. Smith, do you have any questions? I'll see you both back in court on Friday, January 28th. If you have a lawyer hired, that's fine. If not, I'm going to appoint an attorney for you. You can both step back in the back. Thank y'all for bringing Smith and Mr. Johnson to court for me. We call the court to recess. Everyone to remain seated.
Court stands at recess.
Thank you, sir.
Thank you. Thank you. I'll see you in 9 days. Thank y'all for being here today. Be safe. See you in 9 days. Be careful. Yes, sir.
Family already leave? Do you know, Josh?
I think they're right there.
They're right here. Perfect. Turn it on. You mind turning it off?
Yes.
Is that fine?
I don't know. Is that yours? I was about to pick it up.
Y'all slide down like 4 feet this way for the deputies.
We got hurt.
There we go.
Yeah, there we go.
Now we're
going to get
it. Beautiful. Much better.
All right, you ready?
You step up.
This is Paul Hagerman, H-A-G-E-R-M-A-N, with the District Attorney's Office.
Okay, so we saw, but what exactly happened today?
Today we had the two defendants, Mr. Johnson and Mr. Smith, in court for the first time on the murder of Adolph Thornton, young Dolph. It was set for arraignment. Both of the defendants asked for more time to get attorneys hired. And so we'll come back in about a week and a half for that.
You know, understanding that they don't have attorneys right now, how long can they actually sit in jail?
Our judges here try to get people attorneys fast. They don't want them just sitting in jail. Now, these defendants have a right to hire an attorney, you know, of their choosing. Sometimes it can take a defendant up to a month to do that. This judge wants to make sure these defendants have an attorney, you know, sooner rather than later. And so we're coming back in about a week and a half at the request of the defendants.
They still have no bond, right?
They still have no bond.
Understanding that at this point in time, only two people have been arrested in regards to young Dolph's shooting. Do we know of any other arrests? Do we know we can move on right now?
I can say is the investigation goes on.
Is Mr. Barnett, he was in Indiana in jail. He's charged as an accessory after the fact. Is he back in Memphis? Has he been extradited back?
My understanding is he's still in Indianapolis.
When is he going to be extradited? Do y'all know?
I don't know.
Any details?
Obviously, with this case, we're in the very beginning stages, but in regards to how long this thing will go on in trial, what are we looking at?
We're at the beginning stages, the very beginning. This is literally, their first court date, so it's hard to answer that. This is a process, though. As y'all know, y'all covered these cases before. Once they get attorneys, we'll start from there. We're in a courtroom that moves fast and expeditiously, and we'll just see where we're at month by month. But I think, Memphis wants some closure to this thing, and the family, and we do too.
But when a case like this, obviously high profile, there's so many rumors, so many people, saying stuff, whatever. Does that make things more difficult on your office?
I don't really pay attention much, to the rumors, and I don't have much social media or things like this. I know who the victim was, familiar with him, know what he meant to Memphis and what he symbolized with regard to, being a self-made person and the grit and grind of Memphis, and we need to get some justice in this case.
Paul, you've been a very busy man. I'm talking about with the Lorenzo Wright case and now this on your hands. It never gets easy coming in contact with these families, obviously.
Well, dealing with the families is, you have to have hard conversations with them, but it's one of the best things about this job is getting to meet these families and talk with them. And they share with you, personal details and things about, the victims. And there's some meaningful conversations and some meaningful meetings with the families. So that's not the hard part of the job.
Have you had communication with Dolph's family?
I have.
Yeah. Yeah. Anything you can share or?
They're very interested in the prosecution of this case. His mother's actually sick today, so she's not here. But some other family members are here, and they're going to. I look forward to meeting with all of them pretty soon.
Obviously, great detective work and everything, but we talked about 500 tips in this case. Would we be at this point if it wasn't for the public's help?
Tips came in from the very start. These detectives worked nonstop. They literally didn't sleep for at least a week or so once this thing happened. I think as far as what has led to the charges and the investigation and things like that, you just have to stay tuned to the various court dates and things like that.
So you're still not releasing a motive or anything?
At this point, I wouldn't be allowed to comment on stuff like that.
Understanding the eyes are on Memphis right now, in the music world, all around the world, just understanding, getting this thing right. Are we at the point where, again, we can go to trial, even though the trial hasn't been set, but we can go knowing that these two were from the DA's office, you all have strong evidence against them?
We wouldn't be here without strong evidence against them. We're confident, and y'all saw the video from November 17th when the two people shot and murdered Dolph. We got the two people in court today.
And more arrests could still come?
Investigation ongoing.
Can we say who was wearing that Bass Pro hat?
I couldn't comment on details like that.
Since they've been here, have they complaints about their incarceration here or anything they have to say being in jail?
I haven't heard from either one of them.
Thanks so much.
All right, y'all.
Thank you. Appreciate it.
Thank you all.
We'll see you next week.